Hi, I'm Paul Wells from AgileJ. In a previous video, we defined a domain-specific language which allowed us to declare something called a book, and that's by this keyword book, have an identifier, which in this case is J1234, add a piece of free text, which is this string here, and add an integer, which is here. However, if we try to enter another book, what we find is we immediately get an error. And the error is that, well, it was expecting the end of file. So what we're going to do now is alter the DSL to allow it to accept multiple books. And the way we do that is by adding a star. And as I've shown you before, we now save the grammar definition and run the MWE workflow. And now the workflow is completed, we push restart. Now, with the new grammar in action, if I press Control Space, then we are allowed to define a new book. And in fact, we can go on and make as many books as we like. That's just by adding a star here. Well, this is certainly an improvement on only being able to enter just one book record. But now there's another problem. Because it only accepts a fixed set of attributes for each record, then it isn't really any better than just giving the user a spreadsheet or a form on a web page in which to enter records one at a time. Well, as it happens, we're certainly not constrained to a fixed set of attributes. What we can do is say add a subtitle, which is also a string, but make that optional, and we do that with a question mark. After a restart, I've now entered a third book, Charlie and the Great Glass Elevator, and if I do Control Space now, I am presented with the option subtitle, or I can go straight to the number of pages. So let's enter a subtitle. And finally, now it wants the number of pages. As it happens, Charlie and the Great Glass Elevator is the sequel to Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, and it would be good if it was possible for us to record this fact in with the record for the book. And we can do this. Now, not every book will have a sequel, so we will make the sequel part optional, and let's put in some fixed text, sequel of, and then we need a variable, and using the square brackets we can indicate that what's needed here is a reference, and it's a reference to a book. So I'm now going to compile this and run it again. And here we are back in the script, and we want to say that Charlie and the Great Glass Elevator is the sequel to Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, so we need to note the ISBN numbers, which is 1235. So here we have the option to start declaring a new book or mark this one as the sequel of, and then if I press space and I press Control Space, now I have the option to select Charlie and the Chocolate Factory's ISBN number. Finally, I'm going to add one last part to our book statement, and I will do this so that I can demonstrate the use of the OR operator. The OR operator will be used to force the user to choose between two fixed options. Because we've added to the book clause saying that the user is forced to declare whether this is a paperback or a hardback, well, that means that there are now errors. So let's go ahead and fix those errors. So yes, we still have the SQL of option, but we're not going to use that in this case. So we are forced to choose between hardback and paperback.